belong on this track!
Yes, I do!
Hi, welcome to another Pixar Movie Review. This review, Cars 3. Stay in tune, and please enjoy as I drive off into the sunset, I guess. Okay, so Cars 3. What is this movie about? Why are we talking about this movie? Other than that being the next Pixar movie review on the list of Pixar movie reviews. Well, come on, man. Bro, I'm sorry. Can you just do it again? Last time. Thank you. Well, I mean, to be honest with you, many reasons why this movie deserves to be talked about, but one of which is very, very clear. It seems to me that Lightning McQueen is getting a little old, which seems kind of strange for a car, an inanimate object with an inanimate sense of reality. But since we're talking about a Pixar movie, there is no sense of reality, I guess. And I guess that would mean that the sense of reality based on a car would have to be implanted in some human aspect, right? So in which case, what could possibly be the most important thing about this movie? Well, the movie's really about waking up to an idea of not being the best anymore. Sometimes not being the best racer means exactly what it means. This movie made in this year ends up being one of the more palatable Cars movies. And because it's the most palatable Cars movie, it usually means something in the long run. And, there's a lot of things about this movie that seem to be great. But we're gonna have to go into detail. But before we do that, who are the people responsible for this film? Actors and director included.
The racing is the reward, not the stuff. I don't want to cash in. I want to feel the rush of moving 200 miles an hour, inches from the other guys, pushing myself faster than I thought I could go. That's the reward, Mr. Sterling.
Use that! You can use anything negative as fuel to push through to the positive.
Well, hey there, buddy. You know, I was just thinking of you, and here you are looking right at me.
Wow, thank you, Mr. McQueen. You have no idea what a pleasure it is for me to finally beat you.
You are about to become the biggest brand in racing. We are talking saturation on all continents for every demographic. Movie deals, infomercials, product endorsements.
Mud flaps?
Of course. We'll be rich beyond belief. You think you're famous now?
You got the first part right. The crash broke Hud's body, and the no more racing broke his heart. He cut himself off, disappeared to Radiator Springs.
Don't fear failure. Be afraid of not having the chance. You have the chance. Doc didn't. And you can either take it, or you can do what you've been doing, sitting in here for months. And by the way, I love what you've done with the place. I mean, the monster movie lighting and the musky air freshener. And don't let anyone tell you you're not working that primer, because wow.
Welcome, racer, to Fireball Beach, historic home for today's great test of speed. Our finish line will be the abandoned pier in the distance. On your mark, get set, go!
Paparazzi. Paparazzi. Welcome back to Chick Picks and Chick Hits. I'm your host, former and forever Piston Cup champion, Chick
Hicks. It's no mystery if you study the data, Mr. Hicks. Jackson Storm is part of the next generation of high-tech racers, unlike the veterans of yesterday.
That ain't racing. That wasn't even a Sunday drive. That was one lap racing is 500 of those. Everybody fighting to move up, lap after lap, inside, outside, inches apart, never touching.
Now that's racing.
Look at here, boys. We got us a couple of rookies. I want to call you Muddy Britches and you Lemonade.
Hey, neither one of them has a single dent.
Oh, I'm going to fix that.
As I live and breathe, if it ain't Lightning McQueen.
Miss Nash, it's a pleasure to meet you.
You've had a tough year, haven't you?
You'd be running practice laps in Florida by now.
Looking for your lost mojo?
Here to steal our secret.
Hood was the fastest race of this side of the Mississippi.
You know, I asked my uncle once how I'd know when it was time to stop. You know what he said? The youngsters will tell you.
Put McQueen in there. Give you some real competition.
Just want to let you know, Ramirez is moving up toward you.
Why should I care?
Because now she's in the top 10.
I'll tell you what, Daryl, Jackson Storm has certainly made an impact.
I can't tell if they have more fun on or off the track.
How do you keep your focus racing against Bobby and Cal?
Piston Cup talk round the clock where we do nothing but talk racing.
Oh, I think we're in for a treat today. These racers have... hey, McQueen! Win one for us old guys.
Hey, Shoot, welcome to Thomas.
Get ready? Rusty's Racing Center, here we go. Good time to hang.
Queen, you can't race in primer, man. Come on, let's go.
I need to get your rusty tails down here. I created a drink in your
house. What kind of changes?
Futile to resist change.
Don't keep those rookies in the trunk.
Good luck in college.
We sold Rusty's.
Eh? You want to tell them or should I tell?
No, you start. Go ahead.
Oh, that's true.
Danny, bro.
Maybe it's best that he doesn't show up. You know, after how last season ended?
McQueen's still not here? Didn't he pull this when he was a rookie? At least it's my grandfather.
Let me put it this way. I'm not losing any sleep wondering where Lightning McQueen is.
Lightning McQueen!
Hey, Big Tex, how's my favorite competitor?
What is it about this film that seems to have every kid wanting to be Lightning McQueen? It could be about anything at this point. Could literally be the sign of something greater in a movie that seems to understand that change and letting someone pass on the torch to somebody else who could possibly be better, and to give it to someone who could possibly make the reign of your said company, family, or something other than what you intended them to be for better. What does this movie really say about what it means to pass on the torch? What does it say about things in the world that seem to be improbable about really taking on something that maybe you're always destined to be with and a part of? Does that necessarily mean that you're giving up what you love when you pass on the torch? Does that mean you can't really do it because you feel it's too much of a bear to handle? If you love what you do, no matter what field of area it is in, if it's something you love, you're never going to lose that grip. Maybe there's something else in that field that could just be right for you. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean you don't love cars or anything else related to automobiles. And it most definitely doesn't mean you don't love anything else related to the things you love other than automobiles. It could mean this, and take this into consideration. make sure you love what you do. And no matter what field it is, no matter how old you're getting, no matter how new you are to do it, it matters that you start somewhere and you end somewhere. You start with a bang, that means you're going to make mistakes. And you end with a bang. Maybe that means you're going to make even more mistakes going into that transition. But remember how I said that moving forward is necessary in my last video and transition is necessary? Well, passing the torch and taking on a new responsibility is all the more necessary. So keep that in mind as you continue on. Thank you, and have a nice day. Thank you for coming to a Logan story, and thank you for coming to a Pixar movie review. This is going to be the next Pixar movie review, representation of a Mexican culture, which means it's going to be Coco. Keep in tune for that, coming out next Saturday. Also, a lot more videos and a lot more experimental type things. I have a big project in the works, and I just need the tools to do said project. So be patient with me as that big project comes along. Thank you for tuning in to the Pixar movie review, and tuning in to Logan's story. Have a beautiful day. Peace.